Good day, people. This is Choice TV, and today we're going to be talking about political view. As we all know, we are approaching the 2023 general elections. Today we'll be having a special guest in our midst, which is one of the youth leaders well known in River State. Before we're officially inviting him, I would like to get your views. But before then, let's take a short break first.
Young Progressive Party, YPP, YB. Young Progressive Party, YPP, YB. YPP, YB. Young Progressive Party, YPP, YB. YPP, YB. Young Progressive Party, YPP, YB. YPP, YB. Hey, she body start with the way. The youth and the pray for you every night and day. So that you fit
over. Okay, thank you very much. Good day. Welcome back. Choice TV. Today we're going to be talking about political view, and we have one of our grassroots politicians in the building, which is one of the governorship candidates of one of the political parties in River State. His name is Winnie K. Danagogo Briggs, but I was also given the podium for him to introduce him officially. Good day, sir.
My name is Engineer Danagogo Winnie K. Briggs.
Okay, I omitted the engineer. I'm sorry about that. The River State people would like to know you.
Okay, basically, as I said, I'm a civil engineer by profession, and I'm here today. I happen, by God's privilege, to be the gubernatorial candidate of the Young Progressive Party here in River State. I'm also a member of the PCRC. I'm current certified and also a member of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. I've been practicing for over 14 years, and I would say this is my first time of being in politics. My reason of going into politics is quite different, because initially I didn't want to go or run for the seat of the governor. You know, I started, my drive was towards how to create jobs. So I formed a group called CRY, Committee of Reform Youth Initiative. We did a research and it narrowed down to unemployment. That's where we find out that, according to labor force statistics, that 43.7% of Rivers people are unemployed. So that led us, you know, to actually dive deep more into more research, and we found out that 23.9% of Rivers people are actually in poverty, you know, and that's kept, even the underemployed rate is about 19.8%. So you see, these are the things that brought me and said, okay, something must be done. And then we came together, me and a few of my associates, and we formed a group called Community of Reformed Youth, advocating for unemployment, job creation in the state. And that's what also gave us that drive. Abraham Lincoln said something, whatever you don't do now, you regret in 20 years. So that's what gave me the urge. You know, at first, I didn't want to, you know, but I got into the system and I began to feel very concerned.
Like, if I don't get it clear, you said it's to affect you, so you're coming in to correct the errors on time.
Basically, we're coming in to correct the error in the aspect of, the job creation, the economic status of the states. You know, we're trying to see how more Rivers people can get engaged. River State used to be a state where we used to have West African glass industry, we used to have Michelin, we used to have Rivcon, we used to have Nuclein, we used to have Pan African Bank, you know, but today all those industries are nowhere to be found. So it has kept the almost 9 point something or over 9 million persons in River State unemployed, a large percentage of them. My party is new, so we tend to do more harder work to make people, getting people enlightened. You understand? Any other part of it, I don't think there's any challenge, which is a normal thing to do. We're reaching out to individuals, reaching out to communities. We're trying to get, you know, youths enlightened and make them understand that, look, we should be the one to take these decisions, not leaving it in the hands of people and all that. So that's basically what would have looked like a challenge. But so far, we've done our best, and God has helped us. We've gone quite far, and a lot of people have been enlightened, and we're still doing more.
Okay, so it's sensitizing the people wanting to know. Okay, as a youth now, and this is the very first time you're coming into politics, and your party is new, have you able to win the mindset of the youth in River State?
We've had quite a lot of positive reports and positive positive response from youth. So far, we've been in several communities and we have seen and we have spoken to them. We've been in several areas of River State. Let me just say, in 90%, you know, commitment to, because the fact is that we try to open up their eyes to facts and open up their eyes to the solutions, you know, that is needed to solve the problems that is at hand.
So what was your faith?
I have a 100% possibility, you know, that YPP is going to win the states. We have House of Representative members, we have senators in representing these interior districts, you know, of the state and all that. They are doing their own best. We are doing their own. We are not competing with anybody. You understand? We are doing what we think is right, and we are taking our time one step at a time.
You are from Bonima Breeze Compound.
Yeah.
And the candidate of Accord Party is also from Breeze Compound. And the candidate of APC is also from Abonima, Jack Compound. Are you not seeing that as a challenge?
No, it's not a challenge per se. In everything, wherever there's no competition, you can't actually select rightly. So I think it's necessary for us to compete. I think it's best for us to compete squarely and let the people, because the reason for the people to make a choice is for us, is only when, the only way people can make a choice is only when there's a clear competitive front, where people can say, okay, I like this person, I don't like this person. I don't believe in monopoly, where everybody will just say, let them come and let's come together and let them choose and all that. No, you're not choosing right. That way you can't get the best. Let the people, let there be a competitive front. And let the people be able to select. If the choosing was supposed to have taken place, it would have taken place long before we came into the race. But we're already in the race.
Okay. I still remain a Bikekemi Okobofaga. And this is your political view. But I would like to know this. You are from Kalabari, and the Kalabari people have been agitating since Kalabari governor.
I'm not desperate of being a governor. Yeah. It should not be a mindset that people should be desperate of running the seat as of the governor. I'm desperate about the people. Okay. So the fact that I'm not desperate for the seat does not mean I don't have passion for the people. The people is actually who I'm looking at. That's what has led me to run for the seat of the governor today. If I'm being approached and all that, I will listen because I learn for a living. But I have my own priorities. I have my own vision. The party has vision, you know, that she wants to give out to Rivers people. So being dialogue, and we are not seeing, we are not getting what we initially want to see. Because the fact is that one thing is to sit down and talk and dialogue. Another thing is to implement the vision. The SMEs in Rivers State today hardly grow. They hardly grow because you see a lady that owns maybe a store, you know, is supposed to grow within 3 to 4 years. But within 3 to 4 years, that store has shrunk to maybe Indomie that is hung on the shelf, because when she started, she must have bought some packs of Indomie. But because of probably the way the economy is, she's trying to also help her husband, help her family, through a contributing hand to her extended family and all that. So she will tend to start using from her profit. Before you know, she's using her capital because she's trying to make sure her family and her extended family survives. So the money she has to use to refuel her store, she's already adding it in the family because they are going through some level of hardship. So before you know, in 3 years' time, you go there, you just see one pack of Indomie hung on the shelf.
But with all of these, before you achieve a goal, there must be an objective. With all of these, like parties have been doing, they go around, they tour around to sensitize the people of getting their PVCs. How far have you gone with your own party?
We have been doing quite well on that. Just recently, we were at a Rukboku community, and we have a massive turnout. Women, youths, chiefs, elders, we came out and we did sensitization. We have done when Omokutu. So we have been going around sensitizing people, telling them, exposing them to the knowledge why you need to use your PVC and why you should not buy vote, you should not accept selling your votes.
I would like to know your view. What advice do you have for the youth of River State?
Most of the things we see right now in the public and earlier politicians shouldn't scare you. Stand for your right. Me coming out and standing for, I represent the youth today. My purpose of coming out, I wasn't cajoled by anybody. There's nobody behind me except God, because I'm a deacon. I came to a point where I got fed up. I'm urging every youth to get fed up and say, no, this cannot happen again. It cannot, we cannot be like, because if you don't make the decision, there's a wise man said, great gathering don't make great men. It's great decisions that make great men. Let's decide as a youth. The way we decided in the NSAT process, let's decide to save River State. We have a slogan that we use, we hold dearly. It's called save yourself. Save yourself, what it means that if you save yourself, I save myself, we will save ourselves. So the responsibility is on every youth of River State to save himself, because I will not be right there when you be making that decision. Your conscience should be so. At that point, tell yourself, look, if I make this thing right, I'm saving myself, I'm saving my future, I'm saving my family and my own children. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, viewers all over there. This is Choice TV. We have been talking with one of the River State gubernatorial candidate of YPP, Young Progressive Party. Okay, one man, one job. That's a positive agenda. Okay, agenda three, he's education, employment, and entrepreneurship. That's lovely. I think I pray God give you the strength for you to face the challenges and overcome them too. Wish you good luck.
Thank you.
Wish you the best. This is your view in politics, and we have to wrap it up right now. My name is Ibike Kimi Okobufaga. Thank you for your time. We love you.
Bye. Oh, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you.